Environmental pollution and climate change. 20 years ago, neither seemed much of a threat. And so Geert-Jan Gruter had no qualms about thinking of ways to use crude oil in the production of plastic. For bottles, packagings, and textiles. Throughout his career, the Dutchman has had dealings with all the global players in the chemical industry and has also witnessed what is being done to this planet. So he made a decision. Nowadays, 300 million tons of plastic are being used worldwide, and the volume will quadruple over the next 30 years to more than 1 billion tons. To make the transition from fossil fuels to sustainable plastics, we have to rely on biomass. But for this, we need new materials. That's the only way to bring about this change. Up until that moment, Geert-Jan Gruter had been solving chemical problems on behalf of customers in his company Avantium. But this time, he decided to do research on his own account. He wanted to continue making plastic, but quite differently from how it was currently being made. His idea, a plant-based plastic, 100% renewable. His vision centered on the chemical conversion of plant sugar, that is, starch. From it, theoretically, the raw material for plastic, furan dicarboxylic acid, or FDCA for short, could be made. The only problem, producing FDCA in large quantities is far from simple. Over the past 100 years, more than 1,000 publications and patents have been published on FDCA. Ultimately, however, neither research nor any of these patents had resulted in a viable method of producing this material in large quantities and at competitive prices. To make FDCA, two synthetic steps are required. In the first step, certain building blocks are produced from the starch of maize and grain. Then, in the second step, FDCA can be made from these blocks. The problem was that, until then, the first step had only been tried in water. And in water, the building blocks for the FDCA are not stable. Without these blocks, no FDCA. So Gruter's idea was to use alcohol instead of water. However, that presented his team with a further challenge. The big problem for us at first was that only 1% of sugar can be dissolved in alcohol. But we finally found a way to dissolve much more sugar in alcohol, 30% more, without any additional stages or extra costs. And that was the decisive step towards a commercially viable process.
And that was uiteindelijk de belangrijkste stap om tot een commercieel proces te komen.
Geert-Jan Gruter's invention has led to the creation of an entirely new technology platform. He has named it ICSI. In a pilot plant, the production of FDCA is currently being tested on a large scale. The plant sugar still comes from maize and grain, but should soon also come from grass, wood, and vegetable waste. From the FDCA in the plant, a plastic granulate is finally produced. The chemists refer to it as PEF. Bottles, foils, and textile fibers can all be easily produced from it. A plant-based plastic, 100% renewable. And a further sensation, PEF actually has far better properties than those of PET.
When
we managed to produce PEF for the first time, we also made the first bottle. And the bottle turned out to have extraordinary characteristics. It was very hard for oxygen to get in and for carbonic acid from soft drinks to get out. So we saw that this packaging material, PEF, prolongs the shelf life of food and is more resistant. All of that makes this plant-based plastic a material for the future.
And dit alles bij elkaar maakt het een geweldig plastic materiaal voor de toekomst.
Coca-Cola, Danone, and Alpla, the world's largest producer of plastic bottles, are already cooperating with Gruter. Shortly after its initial public offering in March 2017, his company Avantium was worth almost 300 million euros. The global market for plastic bottles is currently worth about 35 billion euros. Thanks to patents on the ICSI technology, this will also be worthwhile for Gruter's company. Above all, however, the environment will benefit from this invention. Making this green plastic produces 70% less CO2 and consumes 70% less energy than the production of fossil plastics. So, this makes the CO2 footprint of the plastic quite small. Gert-Jan Gruter is certainly making his mark on the way towards a sustainable future for us all.